video, let us look at this very important topic of surgery for you called keloid. So, keloid is nothing but it's a type of scar, okay? So, basically, wound healing will lead to scar, right? So, that scar, there are many types of scar, in that one of them is keloid. So, basically, keloid is what? It is persistent excessive growth of the scar beyond its margin. Let us look at all these words, into the adjacent skin. Okay, so let us look at this. It's a persistent, that means it is staying there, it's continuing to stay there. It is excessive growth of what? Of the scar. It is excessive growth of the scar beyond its margin. Where is it going? Into the adjacent skin. Okay, so look at this. So let us say the injury was somewhere and the healing has occurred, but the scar is persistent, it is excessive in growth, it's beyond its margin, into the adjacent skin. Okay, the next point is, it develops 3 months to years after the trauma. It is progressive, so it keeps on increasing. So basically, 3 months to years, look at this, years, even years, right? So it is progressive, it keeps on growing. That is what it is, keloid, okay? Now, where and all locations, common locations they have given here. We'll look at this in a later point. Now, keloid, you have understood the basics. It's a type of scar. It's excessive growth of the scar beyond its margin into the adjacent skin. It is persistent. It will be there only. It will not go away. It is progressive. That means it keeps increasing size years later. Okay, keloid. So, basically, keloid means like a claw. And it is very common in blacks, it's common in females. So this should remind you, females, okay, then, what else? It is genetically predisposed, often familial. So basically, it is genetically predisposed. Many people are, genetically, they will have keloid, they can have keloid, okay. So what will you remember here? Blacks and females affected more genetically, so it is familial, they are saying. There is defect in maturation and stabilization of collagen fibers. There is a defect. Defect in what? In the collagen. Okay, collagen. So what of the collagen? Collagen fibrils, maturation and stabilization. Okay. Normal collagen bundles are absent. So some abnormal collagen will be there. Okay, keloid continues to grow even after 6 months. They may be like for years, okay? Then what else? It may extend into adjacent normal skin. That's what we saw in the definition, right? Pay attention, guys. Okay, are you listening? So, it extends into the adjacent normal skin. Yes, we saw that. It is brownish black, pinkish black. Where is it black? It doesn't look black at all. Brownish black, pinkish black due to vascularity. Okay, it is painful. It is painful. Keloids are painful. Okay, they are painful. They are tender. They are sometimes hyperesthetic. Hyperesthetic means what? That is like more sensitive. More sensation. More sensation thing you can say. Okay. Then, more sensation. And it spreads and causes itching. Itching is also there now. Okay. So there is the sensation in this is more. Itching is more. It's painful. It's brownish black, pinkish black that we don't see at all in these photos. They continue to grow. They don't have normal collagen bundles. They have some defective collagen in them. Okay. Let's remember like that. Then genetically they are predisposed. Common in blacks and females. Now let's continue. How's it going, people? Shall we continue? So we are currently here. The keloid may be associated with Ehlers-Danlos syndrome or scleroderma. What is this Ehlers-Danlos syndrome? So basically, it is some inherited disorder, affects the skin. So let us look at some images to understand better. Overly flexible kind of things. Ehlers-Danlos syndrome. They're so flexible. Flexible people, Ehlers-Danlos syndrome. If you meet them anywhere, you can live with them. They are so flexible. Here there is something opposite. Chronic hardening scleroderma. Chronic hardening and tightening of skin and connective tissues. Strange again. So these people can have keloids, isn't it? When keloid occurs following an unnoticed trauma, without scar formation, it is called spontaneous keloid. This is seen in Negroes, a term I wonder they use now or not, but that's what the textbook says. So, spontaneous keloid, there is a terminology here, unnoticed trauma, okay, and there's a keloid. You don't even know what happened and you have a keloid, spontaneous keloid. Some keloids occasionally become non-progressive after initial growth. Some keloids are very good, okay. This is like, see, I'll grow this much and I stop here, you know, I don't want to grow more. But there are some keloids which want to grow more. There are some which are non-progressive, some which are progressive. Pathologically, keloid contains proliferative immature fibroblasts. Immature people are there in that. Proliferative, yes, yes, always growing people are there in it. Pay attention, guys. Growing people are there in this keloid. Who are there? Who are those people? Fibroblasts. Proliferating immature blood vessels are there. Obviously, nice. Blood supply also they are taking from us. Proliferating immature blood vessels. Immature is a nice word. Proliferating immature blood vessels. Type 3 thick collagen stroma. Which type of collagen? Type 3. In what keloid? Keloid type 3 collagen. So all these pink things are keloid, isn't it? I mean collagen, isn't it? Type 3. Which collagen? Type 3. So this slide is over, guys. We'll move to the next one. What are we looking at today? Keloid. Where are the sites? Now let's look at the sites. Sites of keloid. Common locations. Over the sternum. Other sites are upper arm, chest wall. Okay. Lower neck in front. See, all these are still coming to the same things, isn't it? So they are saying over the sternum, upper arm, chest wall, lower neck in front. If you see, somehow it seems to be pointing to this location always. Lower neck in front, chest wall, over the sternum, upper arm. Isn't it? Let's read further here about the site. Occurs in triangular area between two shoulder points and ziphy sternum. See? Triangular area between two shoulder points. Shoulder. Triangular area between two shoulder points and ziphy sternum. Ziphy sternum is where? Here, isn't it? Ziphy sternum. So, two shoulder points, ziphy sternum. This triangular area. Pre-sternal area is the commonest site. Pre-sternal area. Let us look at the images now. One by one, what we have seen so far and try to see if we found something. Keloid over the sternum. Okay, this one is a keloid over the sternum, butterfly shaped, commonest site. Wow. Okay, we got this. Then upper part of arm near shoulder. Near shoulder. Yeah. It looks like shoulder, right? Common site of occurrence. Okay, then ear. No, this was not the common site, but here they have done a parotidectomy. So, after the surgery, this person has got a keloid here. Okay. Moving on. We saw these images. This is a common site. What do you say, guys? This chest wall near shoulders. This is a common site. This one, earlobe, not a common site, isn't it? Now, if you have understood the sites, let's move on. Okay, we're looking at keloid. What it is a type of scar. Now, differential diagnosis for keloid is hypertrophic scar. Basically, in both these hypertrophic scar and keloid, both of these guys, pay attention here, in both of these hypertrophic scar and keloid, okay, there will be altered collagen synthesis in the wound healing process, in both, okay. Differential diagnosis. So in both, altered collagen synthesis will be there. In both of them, what will be there? Altered collagen synthesis. Okay. In both hypertrophic scar and keloid. But this is a hypertrophic scar, they are saying. See, this is hypertrophic scar. But doesn't it look so much like a keloid? Maybe we have to still learn the differences between them. So basically, in a hypertrophic scar, increased the collagen synthesis is increased 3 to 6 times. And in a keloid, the collagen synthesis is 20 times. What the hell? So, keloid, the collagen synthesis is 20 times. Hypertrophic is just 3 to 6 times. So, kind of similar, isn't it? The both have similar issues, collagen synthesis issue. Look at this diagram here. Diagrammatic representation of linear scar, hypertrophic scar and keloid scar. Okay, so let us look at the linear scar. Linear scar, you can see here, if this is epidermis and dermis, inside how it is there shown here, epidermis, dermis, here this is a linear scar. Scar is linear. Okay. Now hypertrophic scar, okay. This is hypertrophic scar, hold on. So basically, hypertrophic scar in infected wound limits to scar. So just whatever scar is there, little more it is. You can see here it is actually very narrow. Here it is little more. So kind of the whatever it is within the limits. Okay. But here keloid, basically you can see here, gone here, gone here, gone here, gone here, gone here, gone here. So basically this extends to normal skin also. It is extending. Okay. Keloid. That is what we can understand in this. Keloid extends to normal skin also. Okay. Keloid in the hand after burn injury. So I'm guessing, is this hand at all? Okay. Anyways, now let's move on. Treatment of keloid. Guys, now we are moving to treatment of keloid. Do you want to learn the treatment of keloid or not? Okay. You want to learn? Okay. So let's look at it. The treatment is controversial. So we are starting off with such a beautiful image here. The treatment itself is controversial. Okay, but what is the treatment? Let's look at the headings here. Steroid injections. Okay. Another steroid injection, excision, steroid injection. Something is there like that. Steroid injection, excision, steroid injection. Triamcinolone. So what are we looking at? Triamcinolone. This one. So this one, triamcinolone. What are they saying about it? This is the first line of therapy for keloid. Triamcinolone reduces the fibroblast proliferation and collagen synthesis. It is the first line of therapy for keloid. Methotrexate and vitamin A therapy. So they are also suggesting methotrexate and vitamin A. So what and all they are telling here? Triamcinolone, methotrexate, vitamin A therapy for keloid. Silicone gel sheeting, topical retinoids. Retinoids somehow links to vitamin A, isn't it? Silicone gel sheeting, laser. We like laser for everything that is skin, we say laser. Okay, then vitamin E. So now why did we leave out when we said vitamin A? We will write vitamin E also. Then intralesional excision. So excision, okay, excision, surgical removal. Say excision, excision words we will make red, wait. Remove it. Excision. Intralesional excision, retaining the scar margin, may prevent recurrence. It is ideal and better than just excision. Intralesional excision, which is retaining the scar margin. Excision and irradiation or irradiation alone. So you can excise and give radiation or only give radiation. Excision and skin grafting may be done. Look at the note here. One note is there. Excision and primary suturing, high recurrence rate will be there. It's not practiced. Recurrence rate is very high in terms of keloids, more than 50%. So what is it? What is the problem with this keloid? Recurrence. Recurrence is a problem with keloid. So probably they are saying the treatment is controversial. So what did they say? Give steroid injection, do some excision. Excision, what type of excision? Some intralesional excision or something, right? And they said give some radiation, then give some triamcinolone, right? And then they gave methotrexate, vitamin A, topical retinoids, vitamin E. What else have they mentioned? Right, what else were there in this? Steroid injection, laser, I forgot laser, that's so bad. Laser, shouldn't forget. Then irradiation, skin grafting, okay. So recurrence rate is high, so that is what you remember here, okay. So we have come to the end of this video. What did we look at this in, what did we look at in this video? Keloid, where is this? On the sternum. Keloid is a type of scar. After wound healing, what will happen? Scar. So basically, if you say keloid is a type of scar. It is a persistent excessive growth of scar beyond its margin into the adjacent skin, which is normal, okay, adjacent skin. It develops months to years after trauma. It is progressive in nature. Okay, then it is keloid, actually means like a claw. Basically, it's more in plaques, females, genetic it is affected. There can be defective collagen maturation and stabilization. And it is painful. Oops, this is what we should highlight because it's painful in these images. It doesn't even look painful. It's painful, tender, hyperesthetic, more sensitive. No, that's why it's painful. Tender is what, when you touch it, it's kind of painful, right? That is painful. Tenderness, itching. Let's not forget this. It's itching. Itching also. So basically, it can be associated with other collagen problems. Ehlers, Danlos syndrome, which is that flexible people on earth. Scleroderma, which are very hard people. Then, what is this? Spontaneous keloid, unnoticed trauma. Suddenly, when keloid will be there, you don't even know when you had a trauma there. Or maybe something like that. Okay, then some keloids can become non-progressive after some time. Then, pathologically, we saw the photo, there will be a lot of collagen, right? Collagen, stroma, fibroblast, blood vessels, we saw that. And which collagen? They said type 3. Type 3 collagen. Where shall we write it? Here, type 3 collagen. Okay, then. Sites, we saw that triangular area between the shoulder points and the ziphy sternum. Differential diagnosis, you should be able to differentiate it from a hypertrophic scar, because in hypertrophic scar the collagen synthesis is increased only 3 to 6 times, but in keloid it's 20 times. 20 times. Okay. Draw this diagram also. You'll get nice marks. See, this is normal scar. This is keloid. Growing here, there, everywhere. Okay, then. Lastly, we reached the treatment of keloid. Steroid injection, excision, triamcinolone is the first line of therapy for keloid. Triamcinolone. This is important because it is the first line of therapy. Triamcinolone. Triamcinolone. That's there in this photo. Triamcinolone. Methotrexate, vitamin A, silicon gel sheeting. Somehow I forgot this. What is the silicon gel sheeting? Something like this. They are saying, okay, so you kind of pressure protecting maybe so that you won't allow it to grow. Then laser, don't forget laser. Now this beauty things will remind you of laser, vitamin E, palm oil, massage. Okay, then surgically they are saying you should do an intralesional excision, retaining the scar margin. This is important, you should complete it, right? Intralesional excision, retaining the scar margin. Then skin grafting, irradiation, okay. So otherwise recurrence is very high, 50%, okay. That's all for now. We have completed keloid in this video. Hope you have learned something. Bye-bye.